Yeah, man, I say all praises to how
I send me out shy, but I show apart for that.
Double honors to the apostles and elders of Gravely Stone. And one to all our brothers and out there push his truth. In all sincerity, in all honesty. We basically I'm from Jameson, Jamaica camp, I'm out here on Monroe on Friday night. See, probably sign I'm the downfall of this wicked society. See, and ushering, you see, the kingdom to come, which is the kingdom of heaven. See, and on this side of the Lord, it, not the whole nation of Israel, but the elect. See, so we're out here for the elect, mainly. See, because look, as we have said, all about the elect on this side. See, and right now, hey, we can see how in a very serious time, see, because we see a lot of prophecies basically see, happening one after the other. See, and like one time, you know, when things happen, one, it's one little, a thing happen, and then you see, after you wait a long while before something else, you see me happen. Now things happen speedily, you see, one back or the other. People say, in Revelation, I can't get to read Revelation, 11 and 14.
It's Revelation 11 and verse 14.
What?
The second war is past.
People say, the second war is past. You see me? The second war is basically World War II. So World War II passed. Right? Go on.
Again, the second war is passed.
What?
And behold, the third war cometh quickly.
And behold, the third war cometh quickly. So World War III cometh quickly. You see me? We see all the moves that we are making. It's basically bring forth this, this third world war destruction. You see, we shall basically be the deliverance of the elect. You see, because in the midst of the third world war destruction, the Lord, the house shall come deliver the elect. And the four winds of the earth, and the scripture saying in Matthew 24 chapter.
And the seventh angel sounded, and there were great voices in heaven, saying, the kingdom of this world are become the kingdom of our Lord, kingdoms of our Lord, and of his anointed, and he shall reign forever and ever.
Because our kingdom will be an everlasting kingdom. See, in that day, let's say, so kingdom will basically be from generation. I can't remember that. Say, try to take the kingdom. Right, because it's a kingdom forever and ever and ever. Huh?
Daniel. Psalms 149, verse 5. Let the saints be joyful in glory.
Let the saints be joyful in glory. And who is the saints? It's the saints of the Israelites. Give me Psalms 148 and 14, brother.
Psalms 148, verse 14. He also exalts the iron of his people.
And who's the Lord's people? The Israelites. He said, the people on the side. What?
He also exalts the iron of his people.
What?
The praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel.
Even of the children of Israel. You see, because the children of Israel are the saints. You see, and not everybody. You see, go back to that scripture that I read now, brother.
Let the saints be Psalms 149 verse 5. Let the saints be joyful in glory.
What?
Let them sing aloud upon their bed.
Let them sing aloud upon their bed. Alright, now we're not singing upon our bed. You see, because we're still in the land of captivity. Baruch 3 and 8 we are yet to stay in our captivity. Where the Lord have scattered us. You see me? So we're still in the land of captivity. We are subject to payments. You see me? So we're still under the rulership of the so-called white man. So it's not about the kingdom. You see, because under the kingdom, we're going to finally be addressing. You see, we're not going to basically a road to go on the earth. You see, as a man of life, I'm basically jump up and get ready to go on the earth. You see, my kingdom, we're not going to work with you. We're going to have servants, slaves. You see, basically, all the work with us. Now the kingdom. So it's not about the kingdom. See, go on again, brother.
All right, okay. Let the high praise of the Lord. Let the high praise of God be in your mouth. Let the high praise of God be in their mouth. And a two-edged sword in their hand.
And a two-edged sword in their hand. Go on, what are we going to do with the sword? Go on.
To execute vengeance upon the Eden.
Let's execute vengeance upon the Eden. See? look at my people. See, what's the double to them double? See, all I walk at you as a nation from night time as slavery coming up. See, so can white men have got double time. See, and all I saw the leader nations we can't escape neither. You see, what I've got toast here, so can white man get wiped off of the earth. You see, dust to the Lord, y'all wash me outside.
Right.
To execute vengeance upon the Eden and punishment upon the people to bind their kings with chains.
To bind their kings with chains. And who's the kings today? It's in the banking elites. It's in them are the kings. And they're going to survive this third world war and destruction. It's in the start of slavery. It's in what I said 24 brother, 21. See? And all this Eden nation of them basically bunker. They're going to join the elites in slavery also. You see, because you know you have them bunkers, all the nation of France, you have them bunkers, the leaders, them. They were planning to go hide out this third world war destruction.
I said 24 and 21.
What?
And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord. Isaiah 24 and 21.
What?
And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall punish the host of the high ones that are on high. And the kings of the earth upon the earth.
And the kings of the earth upon the earth. And what the kings of the earth right now? The banking elite. You see me? Them are the one who be a scalding head for Esau. Them are the one who be a scalding go for this world. You see me? Tell us that the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. And who is the wicked? Malachi 1 and 4. Edom, thou shalt call him the bad of wickedness.
Right.
And who are Edomites today? You so-called white people. You see, Jesus said, to bind their kings with chains, starting with the banking elites and all these Eden nations. You see me, all them leaders across the world. You see me, of them Eden nations, all them are basically going to slavery along with the so-called white man. Start, you see me, first cup of slavery. What?
And
then, to bury all the dead bodies, you see me, after this third world war destruction.
Right.
What?
And they shall be gathered together as prisoners are gathered in the pit,
run.
And shall be shut up in the prison. And after many days shall they be visited.
And after many days they shall be visited, the other. You see me? And get to work. See? All the dead bodies they're telling Ezekiel. Ezekiel 39. You see, they're going to basically bury dead bodies there. They must start clean up basically land. Give me that person, then pray that finish it. Ezekiel 39 and 15, please.
Ezekiel. Ezekiel 39 and 11.
What?
And it shall come to pass in that day that I will give unto Gog a place there of graves in Israel.
Gun.
The valley of the passengers and the east of the sea.
Gun. So them work by starting to bury the dead bodies. Then I know you have a lot of dead bodies. See, because a lot of people don't get the dead bodies still good. You know, still good for destruction. See. So you know, I hope nobody can be a skull lining. I'd be a skull drunk, so I'm going to get the bodies in. Bury them. All of the nations before they basically start on slavery, go on.
The valley of the passengers and the east of the sea, and it shall stop the noses of the passengers, and there shall they bury Gog and all his multitude, and they shall call it the valley of Haman Gog, and 7 months shall the house of Israel be burying of them, that they may cleanse the land. Yet all the people of the land shall bury them, and it shall be to them a renown the day that I shall be glorified, said the Lord God.
God. What?
Verse 14.
What?
And they shall sever out men of continual employment.
Slavery. You see me, so the banking elites and all these Eden nations, you see, will survive this third world war destruction. You see me, all them will start slavery. They will start to bury the dead bodies, them as me, I said. What?
And pass into the land to bury with the passengers.
Gone.
Those that remain upon the face of the earth to cleanse it.
Gone, because as me, I said, a whole lot of people are going to die in this third world war destruction. Yeah. You see me, and the banking elite plan is, you see, to get rid of the majority of the earth population. When the other guys told us, what? Maintain our humanity on 500 million. On 500 million, and present now we have over 7 billion people on the earth. You see, See, so a lot of people are basically killer. See, so you have a lot of dead people basically like the ground, as me said, one brother.
Cleanse it. After the end of 7 months shall they search.
God.
And the passengers that pass through the land, when any seeth a man's bone.
So you have basically on a walk on, you see me, and I put up a mark with all the dead bodies in there. I don't know what they want to see the stink to.
Right.
See, they can't even take about the carcasses. You see, the stink shall come up out of them for the carcasses. So you have a man walk on and put a mark with all the dead bodies in there, basically buried. Hey, I'm gonna give them a shovel for basically bury them there, and I'm gonna use the hand and dig them and hole it.
Right.
What? That's really. What?
And they shall, when any seeth a man's bone, then shall he set up a sign by it, till the buriers have buried it in the valley of Haman Gog.
Done. What is it there?
Verse 8. To bind their kings with chains,
God.
And their nobles with fetters of iron.
God. I told them I got, them I get basically bind up chains, and the nobles with fetters of iron. What?
To execute upon them the judgment written.
God.
This honor of all the chains, praise the Lord.
God, is it to the point of what? Judgment written. It was either to the captivity, shall go into captivity.
Right.
Yes.
Daniel 7 and verse 25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High,
God.
And shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
God. And he shall speak what great word against the Most High. He said, and wear out the saints of the Most High. He said, and the word wear out back to harass constantly. You see? So, because right now, hey, we've been being wear out by the so called white man right now. See what?
And think to change times and laws.
God.
And they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time.
God.
But the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and to destroy it unto the end. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High.
God, I was the saints as I said earlier, the Israelites. See, because I read the scripture earlier in Psalms 48 and 40. See, the saints are the Israelites. You see me, I was the Israelites today. You see me, people are the saints. So. What?
And to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom.
Kingdom is an everlasting kingdom.
And our dominions shall serve and obey him.
God.
Either to is the end of the matter.
God, so our kingdoms are everlasting kingdom. God, there's no end to our kingdom. See, like the so-called white man, rich end of the so-called white man kingdom. Hey, our kingdom gonna look.